NBC celebrates America with a special program saluting the bicentennial year.
From the Myriad Convention Center in the heart of America, Oklahoma City, welcome to television's special annual salute to the 4th of July, the Stars and Stripes Show! Brought to you by the quality products of Thomas J. Lipton. Lipton, the brisk tea, Wishbone salad dressing, Lipton soup mixes. Starring Bob Hope, Juliet Prowse, and John Davidson. Special guest star Anita Bryant. Charlie Pride. Astronaut Gene Cernan. Les Brown and his band of renown. The Strategic Air Command Band under the direction of Major Lauren Johnson. John Blackwell's Stars and Stripes Chorale. The Dancing Cisco Wrangler Belles. And the Mike Kerr Congregation.
I'm just a flag in America, a citizen I'm really proud to be. I'm just a flag waving American, a liberty loving red, white, and blue variety. I love to sing the battle hymn and Yankee Doodle. I'm thrilled to see your glory flying high. Oh, I'm just a flag waving American, who believes there's no better land beneath the sky.
Now, here's the host of your Stars and Stripes show, John Davidson.
Smell sweet when the wind comes right behind the rain. Oh, the home of every night, my honey lamb and I. We sail alone and watch our heart making lazy circles in the sky. We know we belong to the land, and the land we belong to is grand. And when we sing, I get my own way. We're only saying you're doing fine, Oklahoma, Oklahoma, okay.
If it cools you cool as you can be.
That's real iced tea.
If it quenches your thirst totally.
That's real iced tea.
You can bet your life it's Lipton.
Lipton makes real iced tea. Make it with tea bags, pre-sweetened mix, instant tea, or in cans. It's real tea. Real Lipton.
You can bet your life it's Lipton.
That's real iced tea.
You're the one. The heat's been getting too young. You're the one. We got the shakes to cool ya.
When the sun gets you hot and thirsty, put your thirst on ice with a triple thick McDonald's shake. It's cold and frosty and shaken just for you.
Cause you deserve a shake today at McDonald's. We do it all for you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Hi, everybody, and welcome. Boy, I sure picked the right song to start with tonight, didn't I? I'd like to welcome you to television's most famous 4th of July celebration, the Stars and Stripes Show. Tonight is going to be the most exciting birthday celebration you've ever been to. Well, this year, America is 199 years young and still going strong. To join in the singing, no other than Anita Bryant, Charlie Pride, and the Mike Curb congregation. For dancing, we've got the sensational Juliet Prowse. And for comedy, well, Bob Hope is the greatest. Right now, let's welcome back one of the top groups in the country, the Mike Curb congregation.
One. had missed. I got me a girl and I kissed her in bed. Oh Lord, I kissed her again.
You know, if music is said to reflect the soul of a man, well, then the music known as country and western surely reflects the soul of America. And for an occasion like this, we figured you'd only want the very best. So here he is, Charlie Pride.
I'm called from the station and I haven't got much time to let you know. Thank you. I've got a ticket for Missouri and there's things I need to say before I go. If I could, I'd have you meet me, but I don't see how I can, 'cause I don't have enough to pay your fare. They may not hire me in Missouri, but I'm pretty sure they will, 'cause they're looking for an able-bodied man. Should receive some money in a letter that I mailed 2 days ago. But when I wrote the letter saying you could come to me, I didn't know I was going to lose my job in such a little while. So now we're going to have to change our plan. They may not hire me in Missouri, but I'm pretty sure they will, 'cause they're looking for an able-bodied man. Oh, turn it. If I'd have had more education, I'd have made a better life for me and you. But your simple manual labor is the only kind of work that I can do. Is loading for Missouri, so I guess I'd better go. And I'll call you just as soon as I can. I'll be sending you a ticket, 'cause I think I'll get the job, 'cause they're looking for an able-bodied man. And remember, I'm your able-bodied man.
Thank you very much. Beautiful. Here's a little, thank you so much. A little song I think is very appropriate for a night like this. It goes something like this.
Mm-hmm. beside me, let him take my hand and guide me, let me live in the light of his love. Till I reach that great tomorrow, where there'll be no pain and sorrow, let me live in the light of his love. Let me live. Heavy laden, seems like all my dreams are fading. Let me live in the light of his love. For a heart that's filled with sadness, he can touch and fill with gladness. Let me live in the light of his love. Let me live.
Red, white, and blue, has 48 legs, and has to be home by 11:30. You guessed it. From Cisco, Texas, here are the lovely and talented Wrangler Belles. Thank you.
Stay tuned for the songs of Anita Bryant and Laughter with Bob Hope.
If it cools you cool as you can be.
Ah, that's real iced tea.
If it quenches your thirst totally.
That's real iced tea.
You can bet your life it's Lipton.
Lipton makes real iced tea. Make it with instant tea or iced tea mix with lemon and sugar. In low calorie, too. It's real tea. Real Lipton.
You can bet your life it's Lipton.
That's real iced tea.
Why so glum, Jake?
Oh, I gotta have my checkup, and it seems I always have cavities.
But, Jake, you switched to Crest 6 months ago, and nothing beats Crest for fighting cavities.
Well, how do I know for sure?
Jake, you told me you want to be a lawyer when you grow up.
Uh-huh.
Okay, let's look at the evidence. Evidence. Crest has fluoride. Best cavity fighter money can buy. Can your old toothpaste match that?
Uh-uh.
Evidence. Crest has over 20 scientific tests that prove it reduces cavities. Those are facts, Jake. Hard facts.
You make a good case, Mr. Goodwin, but the real judge is going to be the dentist. Mr. Goodwin, evidence. I just had a great checkup.
You know, Jake, you stick with Crest and you could end up being the lawyer with the best teeth in town.
Evidence.
Evidence.
Crest is accepted by the American Dental Association.
You can't beat Crest for fighting cavities.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here is the incredible Bob Hope.
Hey, you know I'm happy to be back here, ladies and gentlemen, with the annual Stars and Stripes show from Oklahoma City. But there's a great crowd. Everybody here is either in cattle or oil. This is the only place I know of where you can tell what a guy does just by looking at his boots. And there's so much money here. When a guy gets a flat tire, he shoots his Lincoln. And the fourth is a tribute to American politics and our men in Washington, D.C. Because of them, we have 199 candles on our cake and enough hot air to blow them out. But I want to tell you, July 4th is a great day and the beaches are packed. 40,000 sunbathers on the beach and two guys in the water who haven't seen Jaws yet. You know, after I saw Jaws, I even gave up taking baths. I know it sounds silly, but I could have sworn that rubber duck was circling me. You know, I really came to Oklahoma City to see a doctor because we've had a doctor strike out in L.A. No, they wouldn't operate on anyone. Phyllis Diller hasn't had her face lifted in 3 weeks. And she's sinking fast. The other day she had a pain in her chest, turned out to be a toothache. She's had her face lifted so often the dimple in her chin is full of lint. No, the skin is so tight now that every time she sits down, her mouth slams shut. I just want to tell you, and you know the airlines are really short of fuel. I bought a ticket the other week. It said from Los Angeles to New York or Chicago if the wind is against us. But they go fast now. They have a new plane now that travels over 1,500 miles an hour. So you know it's not to deliver the mail. How about the mail? I'm still getting Life magazine. And things are sure happening around this country. You know, the CIA. How about the CIA spying on us? And you all thought that little man in your tidy bowl was just a commercial, huh? Now, did you read where the CIA made a deal with the mafia to knock off Castro? Imagine the mafia working with the CIA. Now you can get bugged and mugged at the same time. No, they had it all set up to knock off Castro, and Castro knew he was in trouble when he woke up one morning with the head of his favorite chicken in his bed. Now, you'll see it all in Godfather 3. Marlon Brando hasn't decided whether he'll play Castro, the hitman, or the chicken. And for you golfers, how about that lightning at the Western Open? That's all my game needs, something else to worry about. They had some rough lightning. Of course, that wouldn't bother Crosby. He's still using wooden shafts. But they tell me it was rough. All I know is when God wants to play through, you better move over. I want to tell you, this is an outstanding show, and it's great to be here with Juliet Prowse. Juliet has one of the most exciting figures in show business today. Beautiful eyes, vicious, luscious lips, vicious lip. I've met some like that. Say, no, Juliet, she has one, I'll get with it. Don't worry about it. This is my rehearsal, too. Juliet has one of the most exciting figures in show business today. Beautiful eyes, luscious lips, gorgeous legs, and I'd tell you the rest, but the idiot card man is reading it. Hey, now let me turn the show over to one of my favorite traveling companions. She's about to take us on a musical trip across 200 years of this country's history. Here you are, a gal I know you're proud of, Miss Anita Bryant, right here.
Betsy from Pike, who crossed the big prairie with her brother Mike, with two yoke of oxen, a big yellow dog, a tall Shanghai rooster, and one spotted hog. Doodle dang, Polly, doodle dee, doodle dee day. Doodle dang, Polly, doodle dee, doodle dee day. Johnny comes marching home. Hurrah, hurrah, we'll give him a hearty welcome then. Hurrah, hurrah, the men will cheer and the boys will shout. The ladies, they will all turn out and we'll all feel gay when Johnny comes marching home. Johnny comes marching home again. Hurrah, we'll give him a hearty welcome then. Hurrah, hurrah, the men will cheer and the boys will shout. The ladies, they will all turn out and we'll all feel gay. Yeah! Get happy. You better change.
then we'll have time for things like wedding rings, and free hearts will sing when the lights go on again.
Ziegler creates exquisite silver. It's the only thing he puts his name on. This is the only thing you'll see the Wishbone name on, salad dressing. Because salad dressing is everything to Wishbone. For Wishbone dressings, we choose the perfect spices and herbs and let them marinate in an ideal combination of oil and vinegar to reach the peak of flavor. Wishbone, salad dressing is the only thing we put our name on.
Chicago, Chicago, that toddling town.
What's a Florida girl doing here in the heart of the Midwest? Reminding you that 100% orange juice from Florida puts a little bit of sunshine into every day, even where the sun doesn't always shine. Orange juice is a blend of essential B vitamins and minerals. And all that natural vitamin C. So if you can't come to the Florida sunshine tree, let it come to you.
The Magnificent Marble Machine, coming to NBC Monday, July 7th.
Starting with her first film appearance in Can-Can, Juliet Prowse has won a reputation as being one of the most talented and exciting dancers in the entertainment industry. Whether it be in a motion picture, a nightclub, or on a television special, you just can't take your eyes off of her. But then, why deny yourself such a pleasure? Here she is now with Ron Watson and Martin Gavin, Miss Juliet Prowse.
My name is Gene Cernan. You know, some of America's heroes may be remembered because they went to the moon, but others, like that great American Carl Sandburg, had flights of their own, flights that were made with no more than paper and pencil. He wrote, "The free man is a rare bird, and when you meet him, take a good look at him and try to figure him out. Because someday when the United States of the Earth gets going and runs smooth and pretty, there will be more of him than we have now."
A little black bug come from Mexico, they say. Come all the way to Texas, just looking for a place to stay. Just looking for a home, just looking for a home.
The voice, the face, are those of Carl Sandburg, a man who spanned two centuries of this country's history. Like Mark Twain and Will Rogers, he was of the people, by the people, and for the people. He was a writer of poetry, collector of folk songs, a one-time hobo, a teller of tall tales, like the one about a skyscraper so tall they had to put hinges on the two top stories so to let the moon go by.
Of one corn crop in Missouri, when the roots went so deep and drew off so much water, the Mississippi riverbed that year was dry.
Of pancakes so thin, they only had one side. Of the man who drove a swarm of bees across Rocky Mountain and the desert and didn't lose a bee.
There was a famous opening to his poem, Chicago. Hog butcher for the world, tool maker, stacker of wheat, player with railroads, and the nation's freight handler. Stormy, husky, brawling, city of the big shoulders.
And he wrote about the fog. The fog comes on little cat feet. It sits looking over harbor and city on silent haunches, and then moves on.
Sandburg was to find much of America's heritage in how it laughed, in its old jokes. Oh, miss, which way to the post office?
I don't know.
You don't know much, do you?
No, but I ain't lost.
Have you a criminal lawyer in this town?
We think so, but we haven't been able to prove it on him.
Say, she told me that you told her the secret I told you not to tell her.
I told her not to tell you, I told her.
Well, don't tell her I told you. She told me.
Lieutenant, if a private calls you a damn fool, what would you do?
I'd throw him in the guardhouse.
All right, and if he just thinks you're a damn fool and doesn't say it, then what would you do?
Nothing.
Well, let's let it go at that.
Papa loved Mama. Mama loved men. Mama's in the graveyard. Papa's in the pen.
I'm going away for to stay a little while, but I'm coming back if I go 10,000 miles. Oh, who will tie your shoe? Who will glove your hand? And who will kiss your ruby lips when I am gone?
Mm-hmm. When Abraham Lincoln was shoveling to the tombs, he forgot the copperheads and the assassins in the dust, in the cool tombs. And Ulysses Grant lost all thought of con men and Wall Street. Cash and collateral turn ashes in the dust, in the cool tombs.
I'm going away for to stay a little while, but I'm coming back if I go 10,000 miles.
Mm-hmm. Pocahontas' body, lovely as a poplar, sweet as a red haw in November or a pawpaw in May. Does she wonder? Does she remember? In the dust and the cool tombs. Mm-hmm.
Oh, I will tie your shoes. I will glove your hand. I will kiss your ruby lips when I come home. When I come home.
Take any street full of people buying clothes or groceries, cheering a hero, or throwing confetti and blowing tin horns. Tell me if the lovers are losers. Tell me if any get more than the lovers in the dust, in the cool tombs.
But Carl Sandburg has never really been away. His spirit and his words will live in our hearts as Americans always. If I live to a majestic old age, becoming the owner of a farm, I shall sit under an apple tree in the summer. On a pad of paper with a large yellow lead pencil, I shall write of these things.
But he's coming back if he goes 10,000 miles.
The Naked Hamburger. Trying to make it taste better can be a challenge. You can pile anything you want on the outside, or you can put just one wonderful thing on the inside. Lipton onion soup mix. Fresh tasting onion plus just the right blend of seasonings. It turns eating hamburgers into an exhilarating new experience. Oniony rich, zesty flavored, crispy textured. The Lipton onion burger. All it needs is a bun.
Real iced tea.
If it quenches your thirst, totally.
That is real iced tea.
You can bet your life it's Lipton.
Lipton makes real iced tea. Make it with tea bags, pre-sweetened next instant tea, or in cans. It's real tea. Real Lipton.
You can bet your life it's Lipton.
That's real iced tea.
You're the one. The heat's been getting too young. You're the one. We got the shakes to cool ya.
When the sun gets you hot and thirsty, put your thirst on ice with a triple thick McDonald's shake. It's cold and frosty and shaken just for you.
Cause you deserve a shake today at McDonald's. We do it all for you.
There'll always be for you and me, the two of us. We'll always be together
like the cat and the cream.
For we're in a dream of our own.
We'll go it alone.
There's just the two of us, and we'll be always traveling.
All-Star Tug-of-War, judged by Los Angeles Rams General Manager Don Klosterman. And here's Mr. Football Johnny Unitas, Baseball Hall of Fame great Mickey Mantle, from the Pittsburgh Steelers quarterback Terry Bradshaw, Mean Joe Greene, and Rocky Blyer. From the Kansas City Chiefs, Ed Podolak, Bob Anderson of the Denver Broncos, Greg Pruitt of the Cleveland Browns. From the New York Giants, quarterback Greg Morton. From the Detroit Lions, Steve Owens. Houston Oiler, Dan Pastorini. Miami Dolphin, Dick Anderson. Detroit Lion, Herman Weaver. Los Angeles Rams head coach, Chuck Knox. And the winners are... Prowse and Bryant!
When I was a little bitty baby, my mommy would lock me in the green. And them old cotton field back a home. When I was a little bitty baby, my mommy would lock me in the green. And them old cotton fields back home. I said, when are them cotton bowls again a rotten? Like you can't pick very much cotton. Just about a mile from the Texas Oregon. And them old cotton fields back home. Well, again, them old cotton fields back home. I said again, them old cotton fields are back home. Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Sunshine of my life. That's why I'll always be around. You are the apple of my eye. Forever you'll stay in my heart. I feel like this is the beginning. Oh, I have loved you for a million years.
Cameras with new pocket size flip flash. Take four flash pictures, flip, and take four more. Wow.
Anywhere you wear a pocket, you can wear a pocket there.
New Kodak Trimlight Instamatic cameras from less than $24 at your photo dealers.
Sidney Cash creates beautiful crystal. It's the only thing he puts his name on.
And this is the only thing you'll see the Wishbone name on, salad dressing. Because salad dressing is everything to Wishbone. For Wishbone Italian, we marinate the perfect spices and herbs in oil, lemon juice, and vinegar for real Italian flavor. No wonder Wishbone Italian is number one. Wishbone, salad dressing is the only thing we put our name on.
Isn't it something? You know, this is our nation's 199th birthday. And I keep getting invited back to this wonderful Stars and Stripes show each year because the folks who run it like authenticity. When they do a patriotic extravaganza, they want someone who was there the first time. So on the eve of this nation's bicentennial year, I'd like to pause around this hot holiday summertime and think about the family. The big, colorful family called America, that is. The huge melting pot of black, brown, red, yellow, white, and blushingly beautiful people who are our physical phenomena. They're the people who keep their noses to the grindstone, their shoulders to the wheel, and they wear their hearts and their flags on their sleeve. That's America. July the 4th is a uniquely American holiday that conjures up visions of fireworks, picnics, soft summer evenings lit up with sparklers, cherry bombs, and red, white, and blue bunting. One of those holidays when all of us in crowds, whether it's watching fireworks or sitting at a ball game with a hot dog or a beer, or spending the day relaxing at home with a smoky family barbecue, can realize and appreciate in a very personal way the sentiments, "This is my country and I'm proud of it." Far too many Independence Days, we Americans have been deeply concerned about an Asiatic venture that punctured a lot of holes in our national ego, that set people and their opinions smack up against each other, and that threatened to do an awful lot of damage to this nation's sense of unity. What I'm really trying to say is that if there was ever really a time to buzz off the old political games and get on with the immense job of pulling together and straightening out this nation's economy, its spirit, and its morale, now is that time. And I'll tell you, I don't think we're out of the woods. It's been said, though, that if this nation didn't have several dilemmas it was busy juggling at the same time, it would have to go out and invent a few. We've got an unemployment, and that's tough because the people of this nation are more used to standing in production lines than they are in unemployment lines. We're still trying to shake into some semblance of order this thing called inflation, and we're still arguing this business of national purpose and just how deeply committed we want to become in serving as both the world's breadwinner and the police force. So I'll be the first to admit the United States is still in deep yogurt when it comes to domestic problems and international intrigues here and there. But I think that like the wise man who comes to a rather important birthday milestone and pauses to put things in perspective, those of us who love this place called America need to step back and see what kind of a land we've created here. We've still got the most blessed nation in the universe. We're still 80 million strong in the workforce. We're still 210 million favored folks on the verge of our 200th birthday. And all of us, the little guys and the big guys alike, can still nurture a dream, roll up our sleeves, and give it our best shot trying to make a go of it. You can knock our land 16 ways to Sunday, and somehow or other, it still keeps moving, shaking, and bobbing up as the best way of life that anybody's thought of yet or lived through in the past. And now that we face the bicentennial year, the year that they take 200 candles and place them in the cake that says, "Happy birthday, Uncle Sam," I'd say it's time we hauled out the vitamins and gave our national pride a good dose of patriotism. Maybe we're a long way from the simple, unabashed days of George M. Cohan, when a surefire way of ending your act was waving an American flag, but we can still do a tap dance, a salute, and a heel clicking over the fact that we got a lot going for us in this wonderful country, and there's a lot of good things ahead. Maybe a lot of people have forgotten a lot of foreign names of places where Americans died to preserve our liberty, places like Anzio, Guadalcanal, Korea, Vietnam, but there's still Americans around who showed the stuff they were made of in these hot spots, and the people who served, preserved and carried that thing called national pride to a new high. The American spirit is as strong and vital today as it was 200 years ago. That's why I'm confident that the problems we face today will be resolved, and why this country remains the envy of the world. If anyone doubts it, they haven't traveled very far from home. I can assure you that they remove the walls, the barriers that keep people in many countries around the world. They'd flock to this country by the millions, even if they had to swim. America is still a young country. Its future is unlimited. Our glorious past is America's gift to us. The future is our gift to America. On this day, we have a right to be proud of our country, but we should also dedicate ourselves to making it better. We're the example of the world, and we can't afford to stand still. We have an obligation to keep this nation as great as it has been in the past, and we have to set the pattern for generations that are following us to preserve this great country and the principles on which it was built. It's up to us to make our 200th and 300th birthdays as happy and as proud an occasion as this, our 199th birthday, and with God's help, we will.
I have been to other lands and places far and near. I've traveled the road that leads to Mandalay. I've been to Rome and Paris and foggy London town. I've thrilled to their legend and story. I've seen their glamour and glory, but no other land can top the USA.
The Stars and Stripes Show has been brought to you by Lipton, the brisk tea, Wishbone salad dressings, Lipton soup mixes, all quality products of Thomas J. Lipton. And Stripes Show is an Oklahoma City Bicentennial project of the Oklahoma City Association of Broadcasters. Galen Stacy speaking.
Jim Hartz for Today, inviting you to the first of a year-long project. I'll be with Barbara Walters when the Today Show presents its first salute to America's Bicentennial from Washington, D.C. Visit tourist attractions with us, meet outstanding citizens, all on the Today Show, Friday morning, July 4th.